Hello, good day and welcome to About Device. Today we are going to be learning the fastest way to batch resize and compress images offline. We are going to be making use of a tool known as RIOT, that is Radical Image Optimization Tool. So in order to batch, compress and resize image, the download link to the software will be placed in the description. After downloading, please install the software and launch. So after launching, you could see this is the window. First thing you have to set is the quality of the compression. You could see here it says what the higher the quality, the bigger the file size. So you could manage this quality level, which is in percentage as shown here, in order to get the best compression you can get from a file. So after this, if you want to batch resize and compress images, you come here and click on batch. So this window will open with the batch optimizer. So in order to resize images, you click on additional tags. So you click on resize. So you could give the width, the height, and you could set it to keep aspect ratio. So let's assume I want mine to be 300 by 300 pixels, or you could resize it using percentage. You want to reduce the width by 50%, you want to reduce the height by 50%, you could set that to be, and you could keep aspect ratio if you want to. So the resampling filter, you could select any. There are about 5 resampling filter here, but I prefer the long course 3, which is the slowest here. You could set any and check which fits your images better. So after selecting how you want to resize your images, you could come here and click on add images, or you could drag and drop the file. I prefer dragging and dropping the file, so I'll select all the files. Drag and drop it. So after dragging and dropping it, you need to select location where compressed file will be saved. You could select any location. Let's assume I want mine to be compressed to the desktop or any location you wish. So after selecting the location, you click on start in order for the files to be compressed. So a warning will come out that the program will overwrite. You could check these settings here. That is where, if you don't want it to overwrite existing file, that is if it's going to be compressed to the same location, it's going to overwrite existing file. So you could check this. You could also delete original files when complete. Keep original date or time. Save in original folder. Backup original on overwrite. So you could select any of these settings. If you want to delete the original file when the compression is complete, you could just select this. So I've already selected mine. So I just click on start for the compression to take place. And then you click on yes, you could see that the compression has taken place. And these are the files on my desktop. So thank you for watching this tutorial. I hope you've learned how to batch resize and compress images offline. Please like, share and subscribe. Thank you.